starring George Clinton. Come get to know the P-Funk on and support the museum. For sponsor and ticket information, please visit www.nolajazzmuseum.org/gala.
Well, good afternoon and welcome to Music at the Mint, brought to you by the Jazz Foundation of America in conjunction with the Jazz Museum right here in downtown New Orleans. How's everybody doing? Huh? Okay. Well, we're going to be getting even more excited very soon because we have Diunna Greenleaf with us today, all the way from Houston. And she's going to be doing a wonderful show with her band, Blue Magic.
Blue Mercy.
Blue Mercy. Thank you. Blue Mercy. It's so great to have a crowd in the studio, and it's great to be streaming this event every week on the Facebook pages of our buddies, the Louisiana Music Factory and the Offbeat Publications. You can tune in any Wednesday and catch one of the great acts that we have here. I'm Jason Patterson with the Snug Harbor Jazz Bistro down the way there. They told me to introduce the band and tell you a little something about the Jazz Music Foundation of America, because they do a lot of good things. They've been helping our musicians out since Hurricane Katrina. And every time there's something that keeps them from getting a gainful employment and income, the Jazz Foundation's right there to help them out. They help them medical needs and housing and legal services, and they even provide performance opportunities like the one you're at right now. So that's right. We love them. So if you happen to be in front of your computer and want to get up to jazzfoundation.org and check out what we do, hey, there is a little donation button there, so if you got some spare change, we can do even more with your help. You know what I'm talking about? So so wonderful to have Diunna here today. She's been playing for so many years, and she's won wonderful accolades. She is pretty much the thing in Houston, Texas, and blues world as we know, huh? What do you think?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Think so. So please give a warm welcome to Diunna Greenleaf. And Blue Mercy.
How's everybody? Try These guys always kept me inspired, motivated, educated because of the things that they'd already done. So, you know, when Muddy started this thing of having a female guest vocalist, he started with Willie Mae Big Mama Thornton. Yeah. And some years ago, I used to produce the Willie Mae Big Mama Thornton Blues Festival in Houston, Texas, a three-day festival. And I'm so proud to tell you that many of the greats played it, including my all-time favorite queen of blues, Miss Koko Taylor.
Yes, indeed.
I don't want you to forget Koko Taylor, okay? None of the others either. Big Mama, you know, Big Mama Thornton, any of those people. But Koko and Katie Webster took a special interest, and I'm forever grateful, so thank you.
But I was wild.
Koko Taylor, y'all, please. Now, ladies and gentlemen, my latest CD project is called I Ain't Playing. You hear me? I Ain't Playing.
She's not playing.
And I am so proud to say that from its beginning to the end of 22 and a couple of weeks beyond, it was number one for the year 2022. Worldwide. And I'm going to tell you like my little Timmy old nephew always tells me, if you want to check it out, Google it. So I'm learning a lot, learning a lot. But anyway, if you are interested, I do have some CDs here available. And for those of you who don't carry money anymore, I have these little, whatever these are, things that he set up for me. So anyway, we're going to continue on.
$2 alarm, I'm sorry. $20 fine.
Thank you.
I know you heard Monk the Funk on that bass. All right, Brandon Jackson on the drums. Tiago Guy on the second guitar. He's living right here in New Orleans, y'all. Okay? Oh yeah, have mercy, Blue Mercy. Don't get me started. All right, let's keep it moving. Okay, now this is a song that I wrote because Sam Myers, I don't know if you remember, Anson Funderburge and the Rockets featuring Sam Myers. Sam Myers used to tell me every other day while we were on tour, baby girl, promise me you're gonna stay away from Sunny Day Friends. I said, yes, sir. He said, say it then, promise. I said, yes, sir. Throw your hand up. Yes, sir. What you gonna say? I promise to stay away from Sunny Day Friends. All right, then. You can go ahead on now. Sunny Day Friends. That's like sunny weather friends. Mm-hmm. Oh, we know what that is.
Look out for them sunny day friends.
Friend is. A sunny day friend is that friend whose arm can't quite reach across the table at the end of the night when it's time to pay the check.
Yep.
They're looking at you. And a sunny day friend, oh boy, I don't want to bring up no bad memories for you, okay? So you just hold on. A Saturday friend is that friend who is always there when the party's on you.
Mm. I throw a lot of parties.
When it's time to contribute, though, oh, you can't hear from him, you can't find him. You know what I mean? I'm gonna have to hold up on that one because
look out.
My check was eaten by the dog. The baby accidentally put the check, put all my billfold, everything, the money in the fireplace. Really, man. Your baby is in the crib, not even talking. You know, you can get messed up messing around with a sunny day friend. What you need to do is find you an all-weather friend and also try to be one yourself. You call a sunny day friend when the water gets high. And you know they got a helicopter can get there and get you. But it might happen to be 3 o'clock in the morning. So they'll say to you when you call, oh man, you gonna have to call me back when it gets to be daylight. You know it's dangerous trying to fly at night. Yes, I know the water's rising. I know I heard you when you said you only have 1 bar left on your phone. But you know, just hold on down there and try to call me in the morning. Hmm. When they get there to look for you, oh baby, all they see is left is your hat. Cause the rest of you is in the river somewhere. So
beware
of sunny day friends.
Sunny day friends.
A sunny day friend says, you take care of yourself. Let you know he ain't gonna be no help about.
Watch out, yeah.
Look out, watch out, beware. Sunny day friend.
Look out,
watch out,
watch out.
Beware. You got to take care. so much. You know, I hope you're noticing that, you know, I write from a woman's point of view, and I write trying to give sound advice. All right.
All right, folks.
They're used to me interrupting them.
One.
Thank you.
chance for love. For my good friends, Smokin' Joe Kubek and Phyllis Kubek, who were good friends of mine. It was their anniversary gift from me. And, every time I sing that song, I can still see them dancing together. We used to double date. And the day that he brought the engagement ring, he said, "Do you think she'll like this?" I said, "She's gonna love that." I looked at my date and I so told him. I said, "What's wrong with you? Do you see that ring?" So, great times still haunt my memory. This next song is a song that I wrote actually for Queen Elizabeth. I was invited over to perform for Queen Elizabeth at the 150th anniversary of the British Red Cross. That's right. This little blues band, led by a woman from Houston, Texas, okay? And we all wore the poppies, and commemorative of that time of the war. She and her younger sister, Margaret, worked for the British Red Cross as teenagers during the war. And of course, I watched the film about this. I watched the future Queen of England rotate the tires on her ambulance, change the oil on that ambulance, and tank off, fill the tank. And then she said, "Maggie, I think it's time for a spot of tea." Just about the time she got two or three sips of tea, the alarm went off. And they were running to the ambulance. She took off so fast that I know that they were being protected and the cameras were there and things like that, but she was on her job. She was not playing. She ran so fast that the camera jerked because it didn't keep up with her. And Margaret was right on her heels trying to keep up with her big sister. She got into the ambulance and drove herself and Margaret to the bomb site. And once there, you saw the children that, because it hit a children's facility where they'd been hiding them. You saw children broken up, bleeding, crumbled. She still did not waver from her job. The look on her face changed greatly, but they got out with the stretcher, and Margaret was a little afraid, you could see that, because she jerked back. And Elizabeth did this, and then she looked at the camera and thought about where she was. And they put two children on the stretcher, put them in the back of the ambulance, and took off again. So that's something that they didn't expect to videotape, but it happened. When I saw her run across that floor, I said, "Look at the future Queen of England running like the Red Cross." And there was the name of the song, "Running Like the Red Cross."
Take a moment.
whisper
like the rest.
You rest easy now, cause you did your job, baby. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Before she passed away, my mother's birthday is coming up, October 1st. Tomorrow's daddy's birthday. It's also Koko Taylor's birthday. Koko used to say to me, baby, me and your daddy got the same birthday. The same day, but not the same year. I said, yes, ma'am, I remember. She and Katie would tell me all the time. They wanted me to remember the lessons that they taught me, because I didn't know until I was an adult that all those people knew my mom and daddy. My mama told me before she passed away, after I'm gone, child, don't forget to pray, cause there'll be hard times. Hard times. Who knows better than I? I finally found out what my dear mama meant I'm not gonna take one jewel out of my crown by lying to you. I'm your wake-up call. Some real, real hard times. But this bad lady saying it ain't over yet. I wrote a team.